Yo, what is good, everybody? What's going on? My name is Matthew Schuler. Welcome to my channel if this is your first time here. If it's not, what's up? Hello again. Yo, welcome to my first vlog, guys. Really hype about this because, you know, I got camera, got lights and stuff. We're chilling in my room. I just want to give you guys an opportunity, you know, through this vlog to get to know me as an artist, but like also as a human being. Artists, you know, we can, I don't know, there can be like this gap. You know, this weird distance between, you know, people who follow us, watch a video, all that stuff, you know, like, and us. I want to bridge that gap, so that's why I wanted to do some of these videos. So it just really kind of help with that. Peeking in my life, you know, in my head. It's pretty good. So you guys who follow me, y'all know that I was away for a little while, like 4 months. So I'm going to try not to do that anymore. I said that in past videos, so you probably can't trust me. But I'm going to try and do my best to do, like, at least like 2 videos a week. And it could either be a vlog or it could be a song cover thing. So into the topic of this video. So I believe in transparency, radical honesty, scared honesty, sharing things that, you know, I guess are the best about us, things that, you know, we would normally hide. But I mean, I think hiddenness is like really the worst thing in the world. If we can be honest about ourselves and our feelings, how we really feel about things, world be a better place. All right, if you have, you know, a unique and powerful perspective, which I mean every human being does, you know, it's a bit like injustice to society to keep your mouth shut. So, pride to the people, keep your mouth. That's also what this world is about. The only thing with, you know, being super transparent and being, you know, like sharing perspective on things and how you truly feel, there's a 100% chance that people aren't always gonna agree with you. It's a really difficult thing with being an artist and sharing your opinions about things, because I mean, people who don't always agree with you, they just often decide not to like you. Your love is the bloodlife of the artist. So it's almost as if, like, artists, you know, you can't have an opinion on anything, because if you do have an opinion on something and you share that opinion publicly, there's 100% chance that someone isn't going to agree with you, and then that means one less phone for you, one less dollar out of your pocket, one less concert ticket, one less view on YouTube, or whatever. So artists do this thing where, like, they just don't take a stance on anything because they're afraid of someone dragging their name through the mud or someone not supporting their arts because they don't see things the same way. This is where, like, our culture just really bothers me sometimes. But why is it that, you know, we can't love someone who disagrees with us? I mean, varying points of view are what makes the human society such a beautiful thing. We're all different. We have a different perspective, a different point of view. So why try and eliminate that? Like, I believe that there are certain things that, like, everyone should agree on. Like how, you know, murder is wrong, or rape is wrong, stealing your neighbor's car is wrong, robbing a bank is wrong, lying is wrong, stuff like that, you know? But, you know, I also believe that forcing people to think a certain way or to attack someone for believing something that you don't is also wrong. You know, tolerance, it works both ways. We must be able to agree to disagree as a culture, you know? Like, I may not affirm you in what you believe. However, I do affirm your right as a human being to believe whatever you want. Okay, 100%, it's your life. Now, obviously, there's like so much more we can go into on that topic. You know, maybe we'll do that in a later video, but what I really want to talk about is, you know, how all of this relates to me and, you know, my art. My whole life, I've dealt with serious anxiety and self-acceptance issues. For a long time, you know, my life's value was based on how many people liked me, or how many friends I had, how many people spoke well of me. I was nice to everyone, I loved everyone, you know, I hung up with every clique and social group, from theater cats to the you know, football team, all that stuff. What, I want a prom king, stuff like that. But, like, I realized that there were serious issues with how I was living. For one, I was using people and their relationships as a means to an end. Like, you be my friend, I'll be nice to you, and I'll feel good about myself. Like, I didn't realize it at the time, but it was an extremely selfish and objectifying way to view people. So yeah, anyone that I knew through high school up until like the age of 19, I'm sorry. The other thing is that it didn't always work. Like, I would go out of my way so much to try and, you know, relate to that, go out of my way to, you know, be nice to them. And then when they didn't think I was cool, or someone they wanted to be friends with, or funny, or whatever, like, I was crushed. I would try so hard to get people to like me, and then when they did it, it's like, I lost like all self-worth. Right? I had zero identity outside of what other people thought of me. And then I would like freak out and, you know, get all depressed and stuff because like I felt rejected. I'm a Christian. A struggling Christian. I think anyone who calls themselves a Christian is a struggling Christian. We struggle every single day, you know, to deny ourselves and live for Jesus. Like, no one has it all together. Absolutely no one. There's one perfect man, and his name is Jesus. That's why we trusted him, because he bore the weight of everything. And basically through a lot of prayer and reading the Bible, which I believe is the divine word of God without error or blemish in its entirety, and the truth that I revolve my life around, I realize that I am loved, and that truth is the only thing that matters. I am loved by the creator of the universe, no matter what anyone says or thinks about me. All my faults, all my failures, all the issues I'm still dealing with in my life have all been accounted for through the blood of Jesus Christ. That's what I believe. And there's like a head knowledge that, you know, most people can get of this, and it can, you know, become kind of cliche, like, oh, Jesus loves you, Jesus is my homeboy, you know. But like, when you actually believe it in your heart, you really let it sink in. You start to act different, you think different, you see things different, be different. I'm a preacher's kid, so it's funny that like I'm just realizing all these things now. Just because you grew up in church or you went to church when you were a kid, I mean, I slept most of the time when I was a kid. Like, I didn't really start actually reading the Bible and getting a full grasp on it until I was 18. It's wild, like the word says, taste and see that the Lord is good. And I finally did that. And he started to open my eyes to things about myself that I didn't know I was doing. Things that, you know, I didn't realize. The scripture that really knocked me out was Matthew 6:1. It says, be careful not to do your good works in front of men, just to be seen by them, because for that there is no reward from your Father in heaven. I was blown away, because I'm like, yo, Lord, have I done anything for you at this point? I'm like, literally everything I did ever in my whole life was just so people would see me, just so people would like me. So I decided, you know, to stop letting my life be defined by what other people think about me, and start letting it be defined by what God says about me. God loves me so much that he sent his only son down here to earth to die a brutal death on a wooden cross just so that I could have a relationship with him. It's crazy. God literally did everything he could possibly do to reach out to me. And all I have to do is accept Jesus' sacrifice for me on the cross and the love of God that sacrifice represents, and stop trying to earn love. Humans are weird. Like, we'll stop loving each other the first chance we get. It's like as soon as you walk different, talk different, look different, think different than me, you become my enemy. And that's just the way we are. We're humans. We're like that. We're petty. We don't like to admit it, but we're petty. But there's hope. Because God is good. And like, I'm super grateful for that, because I need that grace. I need the goodness of God in my life. I'm broken. I'm messed up. I'm insecure. That's why it's so relieving to have God's love. He loves you and me, and he loves us even if we don't love him back. You know, that's the beautiful thing, and that's what he teaches in his word, like to love others with a pure love, regardless of whether they accept that love or reject that love. I mean, you love anyway. To do unto others as you would have them do unto you, like the golden rule everybody knows, you know. But it's like, we have to put others before ourselves, and I don't know, it's weird. We're all selfish. I know I am. And not everyone is going to agree with me. I mean, I'm prepared for that. Like, if you hate me for what I believe in, well, that's your choice. I mean, I can't change your heart, you know? But I am going to love you, regardless. And this time, it won't be because I want something from you. Just to make me feel better about myself. As an artist, you know, being super transparent and, you know, taking a stand for what you believe in, like, it's super hard because, you know, you want to please everyone, you want, you know, people to support you and, you know, buy your music, watch your videos, come out to concerts and stuff like that. But for me to have to be silent about everything I believe in, you know, out of fear, it's like living a lie. and denying the most important part of me. And I just can't do that. It's not worth it for me. So I'm going to continue doing songs, you know, that I like, doing covers and you know, the songs that you guys want to hear, and writing music and making art, you know, about love, devotion, friendship, relationships, everything, you know, that I think are important in life. And hopefully enough people want to come along for the ride so that I can make a living. I know that I can't please everyone. I don't believe any of us can, if we actually want to stand for something. Yo, I love you guys so much. Thank you so much for watching this video. Subscribe if you want to see more content like this. Let me know what you guys think about this video and everything I share with you guys. I really just kind of put my heart out there. Yeah, that's what I want these vlogs to be about. Just to get to see, you know, who Matthew Trooper is. If you loved it, let me know. If you hated it, let me know. Do your best not to fight. In the comment section, I feel like it's a lost cause, but I'm asking anyway. Let's love each other. All right, that's it. I love you so much, and I will see you in a few days. Whether you love me or whether you hate me, I'm going to be who I was created to be. Peace.